10th-ranked Wildcats hosting the BYU Cougars in the first meeting ever between these two programs. This is Friday Night Heights. Thanks for joining us. I'm Maggie Davis alongside former UK head coach Leah Little. And Leah, I don't know if it's something in the air or what, but we both think we are on the cusp of a potentially record-breaking night tonight.
I think so. I feel it. There's just something about Rupp Arena, maybe.
Something about this venue. The Wildcats have made it their home this season, but the BYU Cougars are here to leave their own mark on it, and senior Sydney Benson has a whole lot to do with that.
I'll tell you what, she's had some outstanding performances this year. She has 2 weeks in a row scored a 9-9 on floor, anchoring that event. They actually have four kids on their team breaking records and tying their season highs. And great performance on vault last week.
Well, speaking of vault, how about number one vault team in the country? That's Kentucky. Doesn't get better than this.
I'll tell you, they're a great vaulting team. They have four 10-0 vaults. And more than anything, they have been landing those vaults, sticking those landings. And as you know, that makes a difference.
Well, Mackenzie Wilson sure did it. She got her perfect 10 a couple weeks ago. And Raina Worley, well, she's the all-around queen of Kentucky gymnastics.
She is the absolute leader and the driving force of this team. She is having her best year ever, and I think just competing relaxed and happy that no pressure, right?
No pressure, but how about two 10s on the season for this senior? We will see her on every event tonight. Again, we're in Rupp Arena. If you're joining us, watching a little collegiate gymnastics, maybe for the first time, here's a quick overview of what to expect. You will see six gymnasts on each event. Only the top five scores count. That's because the lowest gets dropped, right? That's when the pressure can sort of begin to build. After all four of these events, the team with the highest cumulative score will leave with the win. The home team always goes in Olympic order, so we will go vault, bars, beam, and floor with the Wildcats. BYU is the inverse of that. Now the crowd getting into it here, and Guard Young is the head coach of the Cougars. He can't wait to see how his team performs in another road environment like this one. He certainly has the experience on his own resume. 2004 Olympic silver medalist, a 10-year member of USA National Gymnastics, six-time NCAA All-American himself. He was a BYU Cougar back in the day. And then over there on the other side, it's Tim Garrison for the Wildcats, the all-time winningest coach of this program. 13 seasons now in Lexington, and he has guided this program to a new level, Leah.
He sure has. And, you know, he came in, created the culture, took over, and has really performed well as far as getting these kids to create execution and stick everything and have great routines. And they have just climbed that ladder. And like he said, they are the conversation right now.
Absolutely. They're tired of just being in the conversation, right? They're no longer an up-and-coming team. They have arrived, Kentucky, fifth in the country. And we're going to talk about it a lot tonight. But they are highly ranked across the board. Delaney Rodriguez is a freshman competing in all-around tonight. She'll start on the vault for the Wildcats.
Delaney, to come in as a freshman, she has had some outstanding performances and just never gets rattled, totally composed. She's just, I talked to her the other day at practice. She said, I'm just chill.
Chill. Not exactly a chill event. Here's her vault.
Is that your ankle full? It's a good way to start off for the Wildcats here.
Rodriguez has been in the leadoff position several times for the Wildcats this season. Coach Garrison credits her with having, like you said, that laid-back attitude, but still a competitive spirit within her, tailor-made to be the leadoff hitter for this team. Now we'll go over to bars, where we see Sydney Benson. We talked about her in the open. Absolutely a cornerstone of this Cougars program this season.
You know, it really takes that senior leadership, and she's certainly proving it for BYU this year. She's going to lead off with them on bars, I believe. On bars, you know, we talk about this, what we're looking for. They have to have changes from bar to bar. They have to have a release move. They have to have a full turn. Obviously, you want the routine to keep moving without stops or pauses. And again, nice landing on the dismounts. That was her release move there. This is the bar change. It was a nice release. Nice handstand on top of the bar. And then she's sitting up for her double layout dismount. With a nice stick. This is Tapacho. We told you guys this before, a lot of the strange names for these skills come from the Olympians that first performed the skills. So there was someone named Takacha did that on the high bar.
Up next it is Cecily Rizzo, another freshman for Kentucky. So back-to-back freshmen opening up this meet for the Wildcats.
I tell you, the freshmen have really come in and helped this Kentucky team this year. There's the roundoff entry vault. Too bad she didn't stick that. It was a really nice vault. She had it there. I think she just got a little loose on the landing, thinking we were done.
Right.
Got to hold that tight.
Next on bars for BYU, Alex Mason.
So Rodriguez in the opening vault for the Wildcats, 9.725. We'll see what Rizzo gets here in just a minute. As we get set for Alex Mason out of California competing next for the Cougars. BYU, very seniority-dominated lineup here on bars. The two freshmen starting things off for the Cats. Back-to-back seniors for BYU.
I tell you, it's great to have that upperclassman leadership on any team. So nice handstand on the low bar. Toe on. There's her release. Oh, she had two nice back-to-back releases. Short on that handstand, nothing severe. Here comes a dismount, double way out, little hop, Rebel Coster, but that was a nice routine. Let's look at those two release moves again. You know, a lot of athletes don't do two, but more and more it's happening in the collegiate scene where you're seeing multiple releases. Very nice. And again, the double way out dismount.
Again, you just have to hold it a smidge longer than that, right?
Right.
Ariana Patterson up next for the Wildcats out of Plano, Texas. Same hometown as Sophie Dudley for BYU. We're going to tell you a whole lot more about her here in a minute. Here's Patterson. There's a stick.
That's right. Ariana has a great front handspring pike half, tito vault. And I tell you what, I didn't see many deductions there. Let's look at it again. It's the front. Oh, I don't know about that, Maggie. I think that could maybe be up there.
This crowd sure thinks so. They got a taste of those perfect 10s here a couple of weeks ago. And let me tell you, Big Blue Nation hungry for some more as this season goes on. Kentucky looking to achieve its first 198 score in program history.
Here we go.
Tonight.
Let's see what they said. Oh, 9.9. A very nice ball for Patterson. You know, if you watch her, she really rises above the table, blocks off that table great on her vault, which is something you want to see.
Here goes Lindsay Hunter-Kempler for BYU, a third straight senior for the Cougars. She did not go last meet, so good to see her back in the lineup. Her season high, a 9.875. She's done that twice this year. Let's see what she does tonight in Rupp Arena.
You know, Boris has really developed over the years. This event used to be kind of slow, and you know, the better competitors. Oh, that was huge. Huge release moves, way above the bar. Clear hip. Well, let's see how she finishes it up. It's been a nice routine so far. Get ready for the dismount. Double layout. That was a very nice routine. I want you to look at her bar routine again and watch this release move if we haven't. See the handstand here. Nice. Very nice.
Beautiful ankle.
And then huge release way above the ball.
Isabella Magnelli up next. Five event wins for her in the vault for her career.
Isabella
the front pike half again, same bar as Ariana did, but both of them did extremely well. Should be another good score for the Cats. Let's look at it again here. Now watch how she blocks off the table. Just a little hop there. You know, the rule has changed this year on the stick landing. Some people may not know that, but they must stick in a controlled landing with no balance checks or any movement of the body whatsoever. So a stick is a stick. We got a little lax on that the last couple years, so they've tightened that up now. So they really need to land it with no balance errors to get the stick.
Well, Kylie Aquinto has been a steady force for BYU this season. Her low this season, her high this season, it's all within 75 hundredths of a point. The coach calls her the mother hen of this team. She calms everybody down, especially their plethora of freshmen that compete for them this season.
I'll tell you, you gotta have a mother hen. You know, those are the ones that keep everybody in check, and they know the drill, and they can really coach the younger ones on everything, every aspect of it. So sitting up for dismount here, double layup. BYU likes that dismount. So nice landing.
High fives for the mother hen, right? I think that might have something to do with the fact she's the only daughter. She has five brothers.
I read that somewhere.
You have to
amazing.
Be calm, right?
Well, speaking of mother hens, here she is for Kentucky. Brina
Worley. Raina Worley, vault leader in the entire country.
You know, Raina was able to get that monkey off her back, excite night, and score that 10 that she's been so deserving of many times, but hasn't quite gotten it. Raina Worley! So Yurchenko full and a half, just a little balance error there on the landing. And she just opened up a little early right there. But very nice vault.
It was a 9.875 for Magnelli before Raina. We'll see what Raina turns in for the Wildcats. We'll turn our attention back to the uneven bars for the first Alvarado sister we will see tonight. BYU has two of them this season. They're lucky enough to have a senior Alvarado and a freshman Alvarado. This is Anissa getting ready to go up on the uneven bars. Little words of encouragement there from Coach Young.
You know, I've coached sisters before several times, and it's really kind of fun.
Coach Young talked with us about that this week. He said it's magical to watch them get to interact with each other and to share this experience. It's his first time coaching sisters on the same team. And it says COVID year of eligibility actually allowed that to happen. She's a fifth year senior.
Beautiful handstands. Shpajnikova. Paxalto. So far, a very nice routine. Giant to her dismount here. The twisting layout. That's an excellent bar routine. I think we're going to see a good score here. Let's look at that dismount again. Great body position.
She's one of the only gymnasts in the country currently executing that layout.
Well, you're doing a double back in a layout position, plus you're adding a full twist, so it makes it a little more difficult.
Mackenzie Wilson had a 10 on this event earlier this season.
You know, she's been very consistent with this vault. Little step there on the landing. Let's look at it again. The front handspring, front pike, 10-0 vault, start value. Just a little bit crooked there. If you see the lines on the mat, that's something else they've done more recently where the direction of the vault and the landing can be a deduction. So we do that on beam as well. So you can kind of look for that. If they're outside the line, step over the lines, you know, the direction is they need to be straight. Right.
So Alvarado turns in a 9.925 on the bars.
Great routine. You know,
Anna Bramit up next.
You know, if you think about looking at the vault scores for Kentucky, just a 10th on every landing, that's why these teams try so hard to get their landings. Just a 10th on every vault, you're losing half a point. by not sticking their landing. So I think that was the problem for Kentucky tonight. We just had a fall there on the bars, but I want to let everybody know that gymnasts know how to land. We teach them that very early, and hopefully they land in a good position where they don't get hurt, which she did. So everything's good.
So it looks like Anna Bramblett will give it another go. Leah, tell those at home who are watching where she picks up on her routine at this point.
Well, technically, I don't know what's here. They're supposed to start where they left off. Like if they have a fall on the bar, they have to pick the routine back up. So I don't quite, I'm not quite sure. She missed again. So very hard skill. And she had tremendous flight above the bar. She just not quite there to catch the bar. So she can't repeat that element, so she'll have to go on from there. See, her hands are just not quite on the bar there. Just hang on to that just a little bit longer.
Bramblett's coming off the meet where she had her season high in this event at 9-9 last week.
Well, sure it would have been beautiful if she'd have caught that, and that's too bad.
Nice landing.
Anna Bramblett.
Takes a lot of resilience to get back up there twice in this court.
And comes out with a smile. That's what I love.
So remember, we told you in the open, six gymnasts compete in each event. The lowest score does get dropped. So now the pressure will be on her teammates to make sure that that is the one they're able to drop at this point. And we have an exhibition coming up next for the Wildcats. It is Claire Stippett. She competed last week for the Wildcats. Coach Garrison told us that ever since then, she has just flipped a switch, new intensity about her.
Well, one thing about this Kentucky team, they have depth. Coach Garrison was telling us the other day that, you know, their goal is to go 8 deep on every event, and they are deep. And that's definitely an advantage to have when you have 6 people and that's it. It's scary.
That depth is why the Wildcats have the top-ranked vault team in the country. We'll see what their team score is. The high tonight for the Wildcats was off the hands of Ariana Patterson, 9925. And we have one more exhibition to show you. It's also back on bars, and here we go. We talked about her. It's the other Alvarado, right? How about the freshman, Alaya? She's competed in this event twice this year.
And you know, my sisters were kind of the same way, the older one, the younger one, and they were here for a reunion, and they're still going at it after all these years. So I'm sure the senior keeps her seniority, and the younger one's trying to move up the ladder there.
Coach Young told us they are absolutely best friends. You see them debriefing there, as sisters tend to do, right? They're best friends, they live together. He said they have the same laugh, a lot of the same mannerisms. And if you're standing behind them, you can't tell which one's right. Which, right? He's like, in the face, you can tell, but from the back, the hair, it doesn't give much away.
See the score coming up there with the fall. And you know, we're in a sport here, gymnastics, where perfection is what you're looking for. It's hard to think of other sports where you have to be perfect all the time. So it's kind of a mystique of the sport.
Perfect down to the centimeter, right?
Right.
Now, Elia's bar routine will not count toward her team's scores, not included in one of those six gymnasts who could potentially add points to the board for her team, but it's a great opportunity to practice in this environment, get some real game experience, and of course for her coaches to see how she does.
Absolutely.
In a moment like this.
This is a time when coaches put people in to see how well they're going to do in front of a crowd, how they're going to do with their routine, if they're going to hit. Sometimes you get in a real battle for that 6th spot, so this is a great opportunity for anybody to get in the lineup. Very nice this month.
So that brings us to the end of Rotation 1, but the fun is just getting started in Lexington as the season begins to look toward the postseason. That's next. Rotation in Lexington, the Wildcats with the slight edge here in Rupp Arena. It is pajama night for the fans here in attendance. Leah Little and myself, we didn't really get the memo on the pajamas,
right?
But we are getting treated to some really high quality gymnastics, and up next, we're going to see the Wildcats switch to the Bars and BYU move over to Vault.
It's going to be an exciting night. We saw some good performance there. Kentucky a little bit off on landings on Vault, a little bit below their national score. Few mistakes there for BYU on Bars, so it's going to be close right now.
It is going to be close, and every little bit counts, right? Because we are moving closer and closer to the postseason, and this fun little number called the national qualifying score, well, it comes into play starting next week. Here's how that works. It's going to take every team's top six scores. Three of those have to be away meets, right? Prioritizing being able to perform on the road. You drop their highest score. That doesn't seem fair. You lose the highest one, the best one, and then you average the remaining five. That's how you get the NQS. The NQS is how teams get ranked for the postseason. The top 16 teams, according to that NQS score, well, they get a seed in each regional. Nine teams get to compete at each regional site. Four regional sites every single year. This year, we're heading to Arkansas, Michigan, California, and Florida. And then the fun really gets going from there, right? You have round one, round two, regional finals, all the way until we get to nationals, where eight teams will compete for a national championship. Every team in the country wants to be in that conversation, right? And Kentucky is doing its part here this season, up to fifth in the country right now, and trying to keep that momentum rolling forward as we look towards the NQS scores, which again, first one will come this coming week. Coming up next, we're going to show you Sydney Benson on the Vault, and Raina Worley is taking the floor for Uneven Bars.
We're on tonight, under spotlights, just might take flight. We're walking in, dressed to the tens, making heads spin.
It's Friday Night Heights, and you know what that means. Collegiate gymnastics all across the country, including here in SEC country. It's Kentucky and BYU tonight. The Wildcats travel to Arkansas next week for another SEC showdown, get back into league play. But for now, we're talking all things Wildcats and Cougars as we get set for rotation number two. After the first one, Kentucky leading by 0.125. Ariana Patterson tied her season high with a 9.925. And we'll get ready to see the Cats on Uneven Bars, and then the visiting team, the Cougars, taking the Vault.
We'll see what Benson can do on the Vault tonight. See if she can back that up that she did last week. That would be great. And, you know, speaking of the SEC, do you know all teams are in the top 20?
It's unbelievable. You know, they say it just means more, and we kind of make jokes about that, right? But you look at every single sport in this league, and gymnastics certainly no exception. Strength of schedule across the board for all of these teams, because they have to play all of these SEC meets.
And BYU has moved into a new conference?
Yes, yes. First season in the Big 12 for the Cougars, as their whole athletic department made that move. Here's a look at SEC in the top 25. We were not kidding. Look at this. Kentucky, second-ranked team in the league right now in fifth place. Florida making moves up towards six. They'll come here to Rupp Arena here in a couple weeks. That'll be a big one, too. Senior night for the Wildcats.
Right, we're getting ready to go here. BYU on the ball.
It's Ava Jorgensen. She's done this every meet this season.
Good vault. Now, you see there what I was talking about, direction? If you watch this on the replay, you can see she got a little off-center there, a little bit crooked in the air. A little trouble with the landing, if you can tell from that angle. But see, she's right on that line, so she's a little bit to her right. So that'll be a slight deduction.
Ava's had a 9.75 the last two meets. We'll see what gets turned in for her and for the Wildcats. Up next, it's Haley Davis, another senior for the Wildcats. Her season high here is a 9.85.
Ellie's done a really good job for the Cats. Come in there when she's been needed and hit her routines. Yeah. Here, bailed the handstand just a little bit short. Now again, you want to look for that perfect handstand. I feel like we repeat ourselves about that, but it's very important. Good job. Very nice routine for Haley. Gonna lay out, dismount, and stop. There's the release again. Beautiful, way above the bar. Here's the dismount, double layout. And she held that position. She did not stick her landing, but she did hold her layout position throughout the dismount, which is important. You know, some people do not do that. They'll pike it down, or they do one layout and then pike around, and just, that's a deduction. So they must maintain that body position.
Sophie Dudley, junior out of Plano, Texas, on the vault. Leo, what stands out to you about this
one? Let's look at this. This is a Gerchenko vault, the round off entry. Not bad. I'd like to see her block off the horse a little more to give herself time to complete the rotation and finish the vault, but not bad.
Next on bars from Kentucky, Cecily Rizzo.
Back to bars now. Here comes Cecily Rizzo. Second time we've seen her tonight. She did 9.775 on vault. We'll see what she can turn in on the bars. Season high is a 9.825.
We're going to slide the mat under for safety. Gorgeous, the Kacha way above the bar. Cecily's not a very tall gymnast, so if she's way above the bar, then she's pretty high. She has great form, holding her body position throughout, nice and tight. There's another double layout. Did she pike that down just a little bit? We'll look at it again on the replay. Let's look at that release move again, and what I was talking about, watch how high above the bar she is. So that's what you want to see. Very nice, and then the dismount, you see the little pop right there, not too bad. Very nice routine for the Cats.
It's Melissa Earle up next for the Cougar. She's a vault specialist for BYU, the junior out of St. George, Utah.
She tied her career high last week with a 9.825, so let's see if she can back that up tonight. Nice vault. And the Yurchenko vault is a round-off entry, so you're going backwards into the horse, but she did a half turn there, you'll see. So she does a half turn out. And a little crooked there again. If you watch the line on the mat, you'll see she
scooches that foot in.
Bounces over just a little, but she stayed in the line.
So. Annie Reigert.
Time for another specialist now for the Cats on bars. It's Annie Reigert, a junior. She's done this routine at every meet this season. She did a 9.875 at LSU earlier this season.
And he's another one that's just been real consistent for the Cats. That's another huge release. So on, bail the hand, just a little loose, but not bad. And he's got great position and form, nice execution. That's one of the things Coach Garrison really is a stickler on, execution. And that was a stuck routine for the Cats. That's really exciting. Let's watch it again. There's that reverse grip release, which is more difficult. Let's see where you are on the handstand. Right there. 10 degrees. There she is again. Beautiful handstand. Bail the handstand.
Beautifully executed by Annie Reigert. Now, back over here for BYU. How about Alex Mason?
Last week was her first time in the vault lineup, and she stuck that one, so I think she might have a spot. Very nice vault.
She had a 9.725 last week. She might be doing better than that tonight.
Good job. Great job there for the Cougars.
Next on bars for Kentucky.
I'd like to see her maintain that position a little bit tighter.
Rodriguez,
BYU.
Up next for the Cats. Freshman all around, we'll see her again throughout the night. It's her second event now on the bars for Kentucky.
Her release. Lots of Tkachevs this evening. With her bail to hand.
Kentucky 3 9.85s to start this rotation.
Another double layup, stick. for Miss Chill.
Miss Chill. Her teammates don't have to be as chill as her, right? I love the celebrations after a landing like that one.
That's right. I think they're happy with that.
You put that bow on, you've got to have fun, right?
Right. It's the stick boa. The lady as a freshman has come in and really made a huge contribution to the team, and always said as a coach, you know, you want your freshmen to come in and push your older athletes, and they're really doing it for Kentucky and I think for BYU as well.
Here goes Sydney Benson. She's their leading scorer on this event.
That was a nice vault for Sydney. She tied her season high last week. Let's see what she scores on this vault. We'll look at it again. Round off entry. Kuchenko full.
Next on bars for Kentucky, Bailey Bunn.
Bailey Bunn's back in the lineup this week after a slight ankle turn last week. They were just playing it safe.
Great to see her back on the bars this week. Phenomenal performer on this event.
Bailey's been a consistent performer for the Cats on this event, and I think they missed her in the lineup last week. You know, wherever you have your kind of standard lineup going and then somebody little tweak on that ankle maybe. So, you know, it kind of doesn't really throw you off, but yet you kind of get used to a routine, and then all of a sudden somebody new's in the lineup, and you juggle things around a little bit. But.
You talked about her consistency. Bailey Bunn has gone a 9.875 the last three times she's competed this season in that event. Like we said, she was out last week. Good to see her get into the rhythm there again. And then it's Kylie Aquinto, who has just stayed in a rhythm for the Cougars. She's also done this event every meet this season. She was the MRGC Freshman of the Year on vault last year, of course, the Mountain Rim Gym Conference. That was the league the Cougars were in before the move to the Big 12.
Very nice vault. And she was had her season high last week as well. They really hit vault last week. So let's look at that again, if we can get a replay of her vault. Here we go. Great ball. Just a little hop on that landing, but you see her distance from the table, so it's really nice. Yurchenko full.
Raina Worley.
Well, here goes Raina Worley again. It doesn't take much for this crowd to get excited. Just mention her name, and BBN immediately knows, hey, this one is a big deal, right? Worley, number two in the country on the bars.
That's pretty amazing considering all the athletes there are. So she's ranked in every event, number two in this event. Go hip to handstand, Picacho. Again, all these names you don't recognize, but this is considered a release move. Beautiful handstand. You know, when you do that pirouette, it has to be on top of the bar. You can't be falling over when you do that pirouette. So here comes her dismount. The full in. Oh, there's the stick.
Beautiful. Loving it for the Wildcats.
Now you know why she's number two in the country. Look at that release move. And look at this handstand. Perfection. Full in dismount, and that is no balance errors whatsoever.
The wink at the end. How cool is she?
She's gotten so she does that. I love it.
Well, you just see how much fun she has out there, and that's been such a big point of conversation around Raina and the way she's been able to compete this season. Of course, so much pressure on these gymnasts, and for her to be back for one more year, to have those perfect 10s already under her belt. And she has another perfect 10 tonight. Raina Worley has a 10 on the uneven bars for her stick in Rupp Arena.
I tell you, she got that monkey off her back, and now she's just killing it. I mean, she's just competing with relaxed and happy and free, and that's just outstanding.
She has two career 10s to her name already, but this is her first one on the bars. Has to be a little bit extra special. See her head coach taking it all in there.
Absolutely. She is racking them up, and just meet after meet. So this is fantastic to see. Kentucky went 20 years without a 10. So this is outstanding, and it's great for the program.
Congratulations to Raina Worley. And hey, she's not done yet. We see her on every
not
minute here
yet.
Tonight.
Nope.
We're going to see her two more times this evening. Nothing can build your confidence much more than a perfect 10, right?
That's right. And the first place she went when she scored her first one was to her mom and dad up in the stands. So that was a great thing to watch. So here's Ms. Stimich. She's going to exhibition on the vault. I'm sorry, the bars. Release move.
Way to hang on.
Right. Lining up to that double layout dismount. Well, the Cats had a good rotation on bars, and I think BYU had a good rotation on vault. We'll see what the numbers show us here in a minute.
We're still waiting on a couple of those final scores to come in, but we know what Raina Worley got, and that's a 10 on the uneven bars, her third perfect score of the season. You could just feel the joy radiating out of this Kentucky huddle right now. And hey, we're only halfway home in Lexington. You're watching Friday Night Heights. We'll be back after this. We are live in Lexington, where it's Kentucky on top, playing host to BYU. First time in program history, the Wildcats and the Cougars have faced off, and what a night it's been already here. And no surprise, the SEC continues to kill it, right? Haley Bryant killing it at LSU, just had the career grand slam. Moore and Missouri Specialist of the Week for what she did at this venue, and then Anya Pilgrim, Freshman of the Week, the Florida Gator, who has been solid all season in Gainesville. Here in Lexington, while Kentucky continues its run, fifth in the country, top-ranked team in vault, and of course a 10 here tonight, thanks to Raina Worley. The Gators continue to rise. They're up to 6. They've improved their team score every single week. That's gonna be a tough challenge here in a couple of weeks when Rupp Arena hosts the Wildcats and the Gators. And of course, you can't say it enough, Haley Bryant and what she's doing with the Tigers this season is phenomenal.
Oh my gosh, she is an amazing athlete to watch. I just love watching her, and I've been watching her in her career. She's like Raina, just keeps getting better, but she's amazing.
Well, we are on the road to Nationals, just about halfway through the season, and it'll be here before we know it. Kentucky, like we said, sitting in fifth place right now in the country, second in the SEC behind LSU in these rankings. All of this could shake up a little bit next week once we start using those national qualifying scores. But for tonight, the only score you need to know right now is Raina Worley, 10-0.
Oh my gosh.
Coming up next on floor, it's Sophie Dudley for the Cougars. We'll be back. Kentucky head gymnastics coach Tim Garrison told us this week he wanted his team turn in a 49-4-5 on the bars. And hey, that's exactly what Kentucky just did, right? How about it? Good omen by Jim Garrison there.
I think he's excited about that. Anytime you can get that 49-5, you know, you're pushing that 198. So that's fantastic for them. You know, he also said, we know we're very good. I love that.
He knows they're very good, but hey, he also knows they still have a lot left in the tank, right? He said, we're nowhere close to our finished product. You see all the accolades on your screen. You've seen them in action tonight through two rotations so far. You're going to continue to see that dominance on display as the Cats just keep on rolling.
Right. There's no question that this Kentucky team has more in the tank. You see the little small errors, and once you get farther along in the qualifying process, that's where you've got to eliminate the 10th deduction and the half-tenth deduction, which is tiny. But in Nationals, it's sometimes a half a tenth that separates one and two, or three and four.
So Kentucky led after the first rotation, extended that lead after two. Coming up next, we will see the Wildcats on the beam. in BYU on the floor exercise. And for the Cats, once again, it's the leadoff, Delaney Rodriguez. Her season high on this event is a 9.9. How about this? She's never scored lower than a 9.85.
That's
so consistent.
On the beam. She's a fun person to talk to. She says, like we talked about earlier, that she just doesn't get rattled. And that's the person you want at the leadoff on the beam for sure.
Coach Garrison called her unfazed. That's just her personality.
It is. She just says nothing bothers her. And I was like, how do you do that?
I need to learn from her, I think.
Me too. She likes vintage things, she says. And her favorite movie is Pretty Woman. Oh, save it. It's great that she saved that. That's hard to do. But unfortunately, it will cost her a pretty good deduction. You know, it's hard to carry on after you've made a big mistake. A lot of times you can see it on their face. Their whole countenance changes. She saw Salto there. She saved that. So that made up a little bit for that balance error. You can see she just didn't plant that front foot and turned her hips, and that cost her the balance problem there on her.
Well, a lot of pressure now on her teammates, like we told you at the start of the meet. Six gymnasts compete, five scores count. Up first for BYU, it's Eliza Millar Crossman on the floor. It's the first time we've seen her tonight. She's a junior. How about this? Right up the road, Cincinnati, Ohio.
Well, they sure produced some good gymnasts up there. I've had quite a few of them myself. But right off the bat, she is really performing this routine and drawing the crowd in and the judges. And that's what you want to do. The floor is a performance. Look at that.
Beautiful.
Oh, she's happy. She's happy about that. She has really got a lot of great choreography in this routine.
Well, she's coming in off her career five at 9.85 last week.
Well, I can see why. It's a great routine. Look at that personality. You know, so many times the fans see a routine and think it was perfect and don't understand, you know, why the score was low or whatever, but they have a lot of requirements on floor that if you're not a really seasoned gymnastics fan, you may not catch that they missed something. And dance combinations, turns, leaps. This is really a cute routine.
And so many requirements throughout these routines.
That's true. And, you know, you can have a bonus combination, and if you miss one part of the combination, you don't get the bonus. So to a fan, it could look like she made her skill or her combination, but she missed the bonus, so she wouldn't get the value for that. And routines only started at 9.4 without bonus. So. Look at this stick on this double back. I mean, that's perfect. The front layout. The front full, a little squatty on that landing, that'll cost her. But I just love this routine. She was fun to watch, a lot of personality.
Well, Kentucky's Creslin Bros is up next. Her teammate Delaney Rodriguez had a 9.675 on beam. So the rest of her teammates will be looking to improve upon that.
Well, one thing this Kentucky team has is chemistry. They're a fun bunch. They do everything together, they say. And they say Creslin is the instigator of all the fun. Look at that front toss. That was very nice. And that's a combination there, the front to the back handspring. So, for example, on that pass, if she had lost her balance on the front, she would have had to have stopped before she threw the back handspring, so therefore she wouldn't have got the connection bonus. So that's how that works. But I used to, when I coached, always had a backup bonus, just in case. Gotta have the backup. Or, you know, the more talented gymnasts can really do that themselves. They can throw something in there that's not in there if they miss something. So.
Well, Well, Creslin is certainly talented. Beautiful routine for her so far.
She's focused and has got a great routine going here and there's the dismount. Oops. Nice routine for the Cats. Just a little bit of balance there, just a little bit of time there. They can't take too much time between the skills or they won't get credit for them. So the judges kind of count that in their head. That was close, but I don't think she got a deduction.
Back on the floor, it's Olivia Matern, the redshirt sophomore out of Highland, Utah. She's done this routine every meet this year, knows it like the back of her hand. Season high's a 9.85.
It's a nice opening pass. Putting her personality into the routine, making it her own.
That's part of what makes floor so fun, right?
It is, and you know, I always like for the athletes to pick their music with a little help from coach. But, you know, if they don't like the music, how are you gonna get into it, you know? So I tried to pick something they liked and it was fun, and when they're in club, they don't get to do that for the most part. Interesting music. Nice. Unique choreography, which is something I look for. Been waiting for her last pass here. Good four and a half. Nice routine for the Cougars. It's her first pass. A little loose there with the legs, and I think this is her last pass. A little half front layer. Second pass, maybe.
Next on beam for Kentucky, Cecily Rizzo.
So Creslin Rose turned in a 9.8 on the beam, and in the third spot, Cecily Rizzo once again tonight for the Cats. She's only done this event one time this season, and it was at this time last week.
I think she was filling in for Bailey Bunn last week in the lineup, and looks like she earned herself a spot this week. Nice flight series. So well done. Was one of those combinations we were talking about. No, the thing about beam, I think, makes a great beam worker is to not give the impression you're on a 4-inch apparatus, but to look like you're on the floor, which is hard to do.
It's hard to even describe. Most people can't walk across a beam.
You know, at Excite Night, I used to put some people out of the audience and put them up there, and they couldn't even walk across it, much less flip across it. Nice dismount there.
Another solid routine for Cecily Rizzo, the freshman. Been a real contributor early this season for Kentucky.
Good flight series, very nicely done, and here comes the dismount. Round off, full and a half.
Next on the floor for BYU, Sophie Dudley.
Sophie Dudley is up next for BYU, and I cannot wait for everyone to see this routine. It is so much fun. She has a blast doing it, and she has gotten better and better and better this season.
Had a career high last week with a 9.925, so I'm sure we're gonna see something really exciting here. Double layout to open with. Music. Beautiful leap. Beautiful switch side leap to a wolf full. That's a bonus combination. And tremendous amplitude on that leap series. Very nice. She's dancing. One thing I like about BYU so far is all of their athletes are really performing their floor. They're not just doing them. They have personality and attitude, and I love seeing that.
Sophie's 4'10", and she performs like she's 10 feet tall out there.
She's getting about 10 feet up there. See what she does here for her last pass. Double tuck, stick. Well, she's got those landings down, doesn't she? Wow, what a routine for Sophie. Let's take a look again. Here she goes. Front full, front layout. Perfectly executed. And then I believe this is her last pass. A double tuck, stick. Now that's a stick, Maggie.
That looks like a stick to me. And we didn't show you this in replay, but her double layout in that opening pass, she worked on that all summer, got to add it in about halfway through the season.
My gosh.
Her coach said that has absolutely exploded her confidence, and I think we just saw it starting to pay off for her.
That's amazing, and it's a tough, tough skill. But beautifully done. So here's Miss Ariana Patterson. Beam is kind of her baby, I think. Ariana is one of the kids' favorites around Kentucky. She's always the one that has people waiting for autographs, so that was perfect. Ariana wants to write children's books and do voiceovers. From Aerie, beautiful done. She's got a great routine going here. I love the music on the beam, don't you?
Yes, I love this one in particular. She's having so much right. fun with it. Something different.
Fits her personality for sure. Switch side. She's got a great routine going.
6-year senior. Her career high is at 9.95.
The Gaynor Pike dismount. And I think Miss Patterson has herself a score there.
Her teammate sure thinks so.
Let's look at that dismount again. This is called a gainer, like you see off a diving board sometime. And it's harder because you're throwing yourself backwards towards the beam, and she does it pike, which makes it just that harder.
And you're doing it onto a mat and not into a swimming pool, right?
Correct.
That's tough. All right, it's Heidi Schooley up next on the floor. Here's a quick note. Her coach said, do not take the cameras off of her. So that's a note to our whole crew, right? She's a total performer. She loves this routine. She had a 9.9 last meet.
She sure did, so. She's having a little fun there. Very nice opening pass. She's getting it there, right? Trying to get the crowd into it. I love when the visiting team gets the home crowd into it. That's always great. That's a beautiful switch ring leap. Oh, here she goes. This is again where they're showing some of their personality in the choreography. Nice little unique move. I think she's turning it on now, getting ready for this last pass. Double tuck. Okay, out of bounds there. That'll cost her a 10th. It's too bad because she sure had a nice routine going, but it won't hurt her too much. Let's look at her tumbling again. Full crunch front, beautifully done. there you see where she stepped over the line.
Next on beam for Kentucky, Raina Worley.
Raina Worley in the fifth spot for the Cats on the beam. She's following Ariana's 9.9. Worley is tied for eighth in the country on her total beam score.
Well, speaking of performing, Raina gives a concert when she's on the beam. She likes to sing.
One of these meets, we'll give her the headset. Let her sing up there.
Give her a mic. Front aerial. Do a back handspring. Back way out. Very hard. Three element series there. You'd be surprised, Maggie, how many times that full turn right there, the little, which is a requirement, will cause an athlete to fall. They're thinking the big stuff, and then they lose focus there for a minute, but that was perfect. Full and a half dismount. Great job for Raina. Let's look at her three-element flight there. Front aerial. Back handspring, back layout, perfect. Perfect execution.
Next on the floor for BYU, Ava Jorgensen.
So Schooley turned in a 9.7. Step out of bounds hurt her a little bit there. So the Cougars currently led by Dudley's 9.825. Ava Jorgensen up next, another freshman.
Pike opening, just a little low on that landing. But I just love the Cougars' choreography. They're doing a lot of unique things.
Ava's choreography is so fun, especially if you have the chance to watch it at a home meet. It is choreographed to cater towards the student section. They eat this up. And it is so much fun to watch when they join in on the fun.
You know, the student sections across the country are becoming really popular. You see what the girls are doing there.
Now imagine that was all of the BYU students.
Right. With a little wave. You know, I'd like to see this sport, and it's happening, become more and more spectator involved. You know, it used to be like major tennis tournaments where you had to whisper, you couldn't talk. Front layout.
Plenty to talk about for that one. Ava Jorgensen, nice routine for the Cougars.
You know, Auburn has a huge student section that mimics the athletes when they're doing their floor routines, and that's just too funny.
Next on beam.
It's a joy to watch, right? And that's why so many people are here. Up next, it's Kentucky's beam queen, Isabella Magnelli. WCGA National Champion All-American, first team in this event last year. Five event wins to her name on the beam.
Bella, the other senior on the team, is just triple flight, perfectly done. Bella's getting her master's in marketing and going to Italy this summer. It's pretty amazing. That was a beautiful, beautiful leap series. I hope we catch that for a replay. Front aerial? I'm sorry, front aerial. I say this many times, but she's just a beautiful dancer. Her lines, her movements, everything are just gorgeous to watch. Again, the gainer pike dismount with a stick. I think you're gonna see a good one here, Maggie.
There are a few things better in sports than a good comeback, right? And right. Isabella had her season low last week on the beam. Great to see her rebound tonight.
Well, I'll tell you what, she sure came back with a vengeance, because this routine is outstanding. Not much to take off in that one.
Well, Kentucky as a whole looking for a little redemption on the beam. In a 48-8 last week on this event, snapped a streak of 49s or better on every apparatus that was dating all the way back to 2022.
Well, that's
so they certainly want to turn in a good score tonight on the beam. Little redemption arc for the Wildcats.
Well, I'll tell you what, they have been solid on the beam the last couple years, and that can make a difference in a team for sure.
Here goes Sydney Benson, little Macklemore to get you going here on the floor. Back-to-back meets with a 9.9.
You know, this would be the person I would want to anchor. I think she's Miss Chill also. Seems to be able to put it together on every event.
Her coach credits her fundamentals. You see those on display here. Cougars also turned in a season high score on this event last week, looking to follow that up here in Rupp Arena.
They sure did. They had four kids hit a season best or a personal best, and that's amazing. Very nice front layout from Full. That was interesting. I like that. All right, coming up with your last pass here. Little pike. Oh, woo! Nice stick. Great job. Great job for Miss Benson again. Front layout, front full, second pass there. Very nicely done. And then she follows that up with her final pass. A beautiful stuck double pike. And she knew it.
That will certainly help the Cougars team score on this event. Like we said, coming off their season high, they had a 49.325 each of the last two meets, rocking with the same lineup tonight. Once we get Benson scored, we'll have their final for this rotation. But up next for Kentucky, hey, we're not done on beam yet.
Fleetwood Mac going this time. It's Haley. May not look at folks, but that's a hard leap to do there. It's a switch half. So you have to turn all the way around in the middle of the air.
So this is an exhibition for Kentucky as Isabella Magnelli records a 9.95.
Well, I knew that was a good routine.
Yes, and Kentucky will be able to drop Rodriguez's 9.675 in that opening rotation, or opening event of this rotation.
A unique move Haley does there on the beam. Went full this month. That was a very nice routine for exhibitions.
We will see Haley again shortly on the floor for Kentucky. Nothing else, what a way to get warmed up, right?
I'll tell you
little
what, nice
routine
to have that for a backup, right?
So Kentucky's score on the beam comes in 49.325. BYU's floor score 48.975.
Good job. Is this exhibition?
Yes, this will be an exhibition for the Cougars.
Oh, goodness. Double pipe, just over-rotated that and went out of bounds. Some fun music. Uptown girl here. I don't know if you know this, Maggie, but they have leotard rankings throughout the week across the country. Did you know that?
I did, and I love it, because how much fun is that? I love hearing their take on it every week, right?
That's right. Elise Rawlings here, an exhibition on floor for the Cougars and having a nice routine. The layup, the full.
Great way to try to work your way into this lineup. Plus, little bonus, we'll also see Elise in her next event as well. She'll be on the beam. Hang tight, I like it. Little fun there by Elise Rawlings. Hey, we only have one more left, but it's Kentucky's program record-breaking event. We'll see if they can replicate it. It's a party in Lexington as the Wildcats continue to roll here tonight in Rupp Arena. The fifth-ranked Wildcats, one rotation left, and hey, it's one they're pretty good at. They crushed it last meet.
They absolutely did, and they say they're a team on fire, and I believe it. And we should see some outstanding routines in this rotation.
Kentucky set a new program record last week on floor, 49.75.
Fire.
Here's a look at how they did it last week, of course, looking to replicate it again here tonight. They'll have the same lineup. We've seen a couple of 10s already this season. Raina Worley has had two 10s on the floor this year. And hey, how about another one tonight? She did so on the uneven bars earlier. Two 10s in one night would be a pretty fabulous way to end this meet. Of course, BYU in the house for the first time ever. They'll be on beam next in Lexington. Kentucky looking to put a bow on it after this. Good morning. Just kidding. We know it's Friday night, Heights, but it is pajama night in Lexington, and the crowd certainly into it, not sleeping on these Wildcats as we get ready for the final rotation of Kentucky versus BYU. Here's an updated look at your all-around scores for tonight. Raina Worley comfortably in first place with a 29.775. Delaney Rodriguez is the other competitor competing in the all-around competition this evening. And when you're the home team and you get to finish on floor, this is the kind of atmosphere you want.
Absolutely, and that is the home court advantage in gymnastics, is having being at home on floor with your crowd going crazy.
And of course, a little bit of home court advantage to put your opponent on the beam.
Absolutely.
For their last night, right? When your crowd is going crazy, feeling the energy, a loud, energetic event like the floor, and then you have BYU trying to stay calm, take deep breaths, stay focused on the beam, those 4 inches that we talked about. It's tough.
You know, and you have the home team hit a big skill and your athletes on the beam, and you just got to keep your composure and keep going. But I think the Cats and the Cougars are ready for a cat fight this last event.
I love it. I can't believe we've gone through 3 rotations. We haven't made a cat fight joke yet. Leah, thank you for getting that in. I appreciate it.
Well, I'm going to say this again. Kathy Johnson, former Olympian, said this last week on Twitter. I loved it. She said, the higher they score, the louder we roar.
I love that.
Love it.
Here's the lineup we'll see on the floor for Kentucky, starting again with the freshman who's competing on all around, Delaney Rodriguez, and we'll end with Raina Worley looking for another perfect 10 tonight.
Delaney is a great person to start off with for the Cats. Again, just full of personality, that freshman just loving life.
You see BYU associate coach Natalie Brokman there saying, take a deep breath.
Yes,
she's their beam coach. She probably says that every day or so to these girls, right? And their head coach, Guard Young, said, I can't wait to see how some of these girls do in this environment, in this moment. You have to finish on beam in front of a crowd that he knew would be a good crowd like we've seen here tonight in Rupp Arena. And we'll start with Alex Mason. Her season high is a 9.85.
You know, I'll tell you, that's another thing about the Southeastern Conference is they've been putting crowds in the stands for gymnastics for a long time. And some of the other schools are just catching up, but it's a great environment, you know, for all the schools, no matter where you go and compete, to have big crowds now. So the sport is growing. It's exciting to watch, and we're seeing that right here on the balance beam. Nice side aerial. She doesn't look phased. She's just full of confidence. Alex went 9.75 last week as their leadoff. She's a senior. I tell you what, I love to have someone like that as my leadoff. She looks not rattled whatsoever. Getting ready for her dismount. Double full. Good job for Alex. I think she's going to get a good score here to start off for the Cougars.
Wonderful start for BYU.
Let's look at her flight series. Backhandspring back layout. Nicely done.
Starting on the floor for Kentucky.
In the dismount,
Delaney
double
four. Rodriguez.
See that little hop of the landing? Little loose legs there in the twist, but overall a very, very nice routine.
Here goes Delaney Rodriguez in her fourth and final routine of the night. Her season high, which was a 9.875, came the first meet of the year. Might have a little something to do with the fact it was in her hometown of Las Vegas. Let's see what she can do tonight in Lexington.
I asked her about that the other day, you know, Lexington versus Vegas. So she said, well, it was quite a change. But her favorite thing to do is to go to Lake Mead out there, which is a beautiful place. By the way, her leap series was outstanding. A lot of amplitude. You know, the judges want to see those split leaps and switch rings and things with full splits. A lot of people don't do that, but beautiful double tuck. You know, Kentucky had their first meet out in Vegas. It was nice for her to have a home meet. She's got some fun music. She's got a good ending here.
Little cat scratch at the end for Delaney.
I think she's happy with that.
We've talked a lot about Kentucky having that program record last week. What we haven't said is how badly Kentucky needed it. Hosting the Missouri Tigers, a really solid team in the SEC. Kentucky with a shaky beam routine. SEC win on the line. They know those national qualifying scores are coming on the horizon. And top to bottom, Kentucky performed. That's what they are hoping to do again tonight on Beam. You could say the same for BYU as they look to get another solid score on this apparatus.
Well, you know, Kentucky started with a very unique situation. Their first four meets were on the road. That's kind of unheard of. I asked Coach Garrison if he thought that made a difference in what they did. And obviously to put them on the road with all the freshmen they have four times before they came home was definitely a push for them, and I think help increase their confidence along the way, but that was kind of unheard of. So when they came back to Rupp for their first home meet, they exploded, and they've just been on a run ever since.
Well, BYU has had one heck of a schedule this year as well. Madison Raisley Patton hanging on to that beam, the sophomore out of Lantana, Texas. It's the first we've seen her tonight. Has to be hard to wait around all night to get up on that beam.
It's definitely hard, and it's hard in this environment. And you know, when you get to farther along in the championships, you've got four events going on at the same time, four crowds yelling for their athletes. So you got to learn to compete in this situation. Trip this mount. Let's look at her flight series again. Back entering, back layout. She just didn't press down on that landing to hold it. but she saved it. That's important.
Well, her teammate Alex Mason opened up the beam with a 9-8, so we'll see what Madison turns in for the team. And then up again for Kentucky on the floor, here's Mackenzie Wilson. Season high last meet was a 9.925.
You know, I've seen her confidence grow. I think scoring a 10 obviously helped. She did that on vault, but she has just improved and gotten confident as she has gone along in her career.
Coach Garrison talked about that 10 and how big it was, of course, for Mackenzie, but also for this program. Put UK in the 10 club. Her 10 on that vault was the first 10 in Rupp Arena. A huge accomplishment.
Right, I think that team just had a coming out party at Excite Night. You know, the two 10s, the program record, it just lit a fire under them. They've been going ever since. Kenzie's leaps are outstanding. Double tuck there.
Mackenzie Wilson.
Let's take a look again. Full and a half front layout, beautifully done. Execution was great. Double tuck.
Next on beam for BYU.
I think they can be happy with this score.
So Madison Raisley-Patton had a 9.55 in the Cougars' last go on the beam. So rest of her teammates will look to do a little bit better than that to close out the night strong. It's Eliza Millar-Crossman up next for the Cougars. She's competed on the beam every meet this season. Her season high is a 9.9, but her career high is even a little higher than that, 9.925.
Well, she has really nice beam routine going here. And like I said, everybody needs to remember the routines only start with a 9-4 without bonus. So you have to look for those things. There's one of those bonus connections. And that switch half leap that we talked about, the 4, that's very difficult. She did that nicely.
And the concentration it takes to do this routine in this environment. But hey, BYU is battle tested in that regard this season. They have played an incredibly tough schedule. They were at number 1 Oklahoma just last week.
They sure have, and I tell you, they really look composed here on the balance beam, and that's great. Front full dismount with a stick. I think they're going to see a good score here as well. Look at
we
this.
Weren't joking, right?
That's right. Look at that.
8 teams in the top 25. Now you add number 5 Kentucky to that list. And they can rise to the occasion, right? 4 career highs last meet, spread amongst 3 events when they were on the road at Oklahoma. Their head coach talked with us this week and just talked about the resiliency of this team, how much it has impressed him to hand them that schedule that you just saw and be able to handle it, the road test, not always getting the scores you think you should get. And to keep learning from it and getting better along the way, BYU has certainly done that. So has Isabella Magnelli on the floor, another true performer for Kentucky.
Well, she loves floor, and I think this is one of her better events.
Mackenzie Wilson just got a 9.925 for Kentucky on floor. That matches
that might be
her
a high
season
score.
High.
Yes. Beautiful leaps by Bella. You know, when I was coaching, just as to your point, I felt like the better competition we went against, the more experience my kids got. So I think BYU's done the right thing. You can sure tell.
Absolutely. Their first year in the Big 12. Competition is stiff there, just like it is in the SEC. As Eliza turns in a 9.8, that'll tie Alex Mason to lead the Cougars.
Bella going to finish up here with a double pike. Nicely done.
All smiles for the senior.
I think so. Isabella's All-American for Kentucky, and it it shows.
Isabella McNally!
Excellent routine for Isabella McNally.
Double pike there.
Here goes Mina Margroff for the Cougars, the junior out of Spring, Texas. First we've seen of Mina here tonight. Absolutely a competitor who has battled her way into this lineup. So resilient throughout her life and gymnastics career. Injuries, surgeries, so much that these young women go through, and she has continued to rise to the occasion.
It's a tough sport, no doubt, but that was her flight series. Nicely done. She has beautiful lines. I love her dance. That's called a cat leap. Appropriate for the Cougars and the Wildcats. There's that full turn. Not difficult, but stressful. How about that? Split leap. Not quite to split on either one of those. Small deduction, but a nice combination. She has very pretty lines on the beam. She must have a dance background, I would think. And the dismount, front full. That should be a good score for the Cougars. Let's look at this again. The front aerial to a back tuck. Nicely done, no hesitation between, and then the front full dismount to a perfect stick. Great job.
Haley Davis on deck for the Cats. She's had a 9.95 six times.
Well, she rocks this routine out.
She had that 9.95. One of them came last week. I think she wanted the 10 last week on Rockstar Night here. Tonight's pajama night, not quite the same. Right. But a 10 never goes out of style.
Rocking out that double pipe. She loves this routine. She started off with a different routine. I was at practice earlier in the year, and she just decided she didn't like the new routine, and everybody, she felt this was her music and her routine, so she went back to her favorite, and it's paid off. Front full front layout. Always nice to finish with the music building. You can tell she's about ready for her last pass. We just need Steven Tyler screaming in the background, right?
I will not try to do that for you.
Double tuck, perfect landing. Great job for Haley Davis. Kentucky's rock star.
How about this? Thunder stuck? How'd I do?
I like it. I like it.
Great routine by Haley Davis.
Next on beam for BYU, Elise Rollins.
So Kentucky just about on par. A smidge below where they were through this rotation last week, trying to match or exceed that program record they set 1 week ago tonight. Well, we have Elise Rollins on the bar for BYU. She's your beam queen, WCGA second team All-American in this event in 2022. She's a senior this year.
She had a great floor. She looks like she's enjoying herself up there on the beam. In her series, very nice. She's a happy girl tonight. You know, I'm noticing this again. You know, none of their athletes have seemed distracted at all. They're just up there performing, and that is outstanding. It's what you have to do when you get to postseason, for sure.
Testament to the schedule they've gone through as well.
Mm-hmm, absolutely. Back way up. Full twist, nice dismount. That was a nice routine.
Beam coach is loving it. Teammates are loving it. Here's your flight series again.
Front aerial, back handspring, back layout. Three elements directly connected. Beautifully done. And there's that back handspring, layout full. Very nice routine.
Here goes the freshman, Creslin Bros. You want to talk about personality? Creslin is all personality in this routine. And hey, she crushes it on all the gymnastics as well. Great tumbling passes.
Zella Pike, and she sure does. She said the chemistry of this team is unmatched.
Team 50 for the Wildcats.
Coming from a freshman, right? It's that 50, Maggie. It's that
it is.
50.
We love a fun number like that, right? Right
that
to
wink?
The camera.
That's how to sell it, right? It's that lead series we talked about. I love this part. She really sells a routine. The judges, I'm sure, are having a good time. But great balls of fire again, right? Seems to be a progressing theme, the fire.
Cats are on fire. Haley Davis turned in a 9.9. That follows two of her teammates with 9.925s.
Great beam rotation for Kentucky right now. Nothing for Flora, but... Great routine for Creslin. Again, Kentucky's on point to have a great floor rotation here. Look at the height she got on that double pike. That was just amazing. About 4.5 stuck. She was happy about that.
Well, Elise turned in a 9.925 for BYU on beam that exceeds her season high. They call her the beam queen, and their coach calls Brindley Anderson the beam princess. She's the freshman, and she is their anchor on the beam, on the road. Doesn't get more high pressure than that.
Well, she looks fully confident up there, and she's singing like Raina does. So we might have to start a new event on beam singing.
Brindley's a freshman out of Orem, Utah. There is something in the water there. Three gymnasts on this BYU team from that hometown.
Well, talking about the water, I think three of them I talked to said they love boating, and being that I'm a boater, you know, it's my kind of girl there. So. Great job.
Brindley is BYU's leading scorer on the beam this season with a 9.817 average. She's a beam specialist, so we'll see what that performance gets her tonight in Lexington. As we move toward our last Kentucky routine of the night, who else but Raina Worley? She now has three career tens to her name. Two of them have come on this event in the last 3 weeks. One came earlier tonight. We'll see how she follows that up on the floor.
Like I said, I think the dam is broken as far as the tens, and now she's just gonna go out and just have fun. Beautiful full in, as always.
You can have fun when you are the number one gymnast in the country in this event. That's what you're seeing right now.
You wanna be great? Watch Miss Worley. Look at this leap. So that might be the most perfect switch ring. She's rocking it out as well. The facial she has is killing me. Oh, there's Steven.
Wink on the beat.
Like I said, it's great to see her having fun, her fifth year. You know, when she told me she was coming back, she said, nobody knew. She said, don't tell anybody.
It's a hard secret to keep.
I know it was. And she adds her little moonwalk in. Think she can do it again?
She's on her way.
She is.
You can feel it building. This crowd knows she's been perfect so far.
It's a last double tuck.
That'll do it for Raina Worley. Leah, what do you think?
I tell you what, she just gets better each week and more confident and more outstanding. And let's check this out again. All the young gymnasts out there, perfectly executed full in. This is her second pass, front layout. I mean, front full front layout. And then her last pass, double tuck. But she's just a crowd favorite. And, you know, it's nice to see athletes like Raina. Did she do it again? She did it again.
She did it again twice in one night.
Oh,
there was a 10 by one of the judges, a 9.95 by the other. Man, they punked us all out, us included.
They did. They faked us out, didn't they?
I think Raina fell for it a little bit there, too. She was ready to celebrate it again. And hey, still something to celebrate.
I'll
a phenomenal score for an incredible gymnast.
She is. She's done a lot for the sport. She's just a crowd favorite, a kid favorite, a great young lady.
She's done for the night, so she can put on her shades. Love all of the decor and all the festivities going on with the Wildcats. They know they've turned in another solid night in Lexington. Wildcat will dance us out. We'll be back after this. We're back in Lexington, where the Kentucky gymnastics program has continued its dominance. It's a win for the Cats' second highest program score this season, led by the one and only Raina Worley. Raina, your third career 10 tonight. How did that uneven bars routine feel to you?
It was kind of crazy because my warm-ups weren't usually what they feel like. They weren't, you know, the best that I had ever felt. So going out there, I kind of really just had to trust what I'd been doing in the gym and all my, like, routines that I've had prior to tonight. So it was kind of exciting, but a little bit more nerve-wracking than anything.
Well, you know, Raina, having watched you now for going on 5 years, what I'm seeing is just finally the monkey's off your back. You're having fun. You're just doing what you love. So tell me how that feels.
It's great. I think getting the first 10 out of the way just relieved so much pressure. And now I'm just able to go out there and really just enjoy my time and experience gymnastics one last time for the joy that I have for it.
Right. I think that's great.
Thank you.
We've heard so much about Team 50. What's the ceiling for this team?
I don't know if there is one. Probably the stars.
I love that answer, Raina. We're going to let you go celebrate with your team. Give us one more of your iconic winks before we let you go. That's Raina Worley, everybody.
Thank
Raina, thanks for joining us on the broadcast. And congratulations on another great meet.
Thank you.
We will let Raina get back over with her team to celebrate Kentucky's second highest score of the season as the Wildcats get the win with a 197-775. BYU back at home next Friday night. Kentucky will take on Arkansas. For now, that'll do it in Lexington. For Leah Little, I'm Maggie Davis, and our entire crew, thanks for joining us. So long from Friday Night Hikes.